Testimony of Ronald Mcdonald, Chapter 1. My Initiation. From the city of Mutare, Zimbabwe, I am a former Satanist, freed by the power of the blood of Jesus. Before I was born, my parents performed a ritual on their bodies at the request of a group of sorcerers. Through that ritual, my father masturbated in a bowl. That night they collected his genetic material and did witchcraft with my father's semen and gave it to my mother to inject in her private part. That semen was consecrated to Satan to be born as his son in the womb of my mother. The semen did not die and was alive. I can say that everything was allowed by God. That genetic material did not die by a miracle to live and tell this testimony. After my mother injected the consecrated semen, they did a ritual on her belly offering me. My mother was chosen to be the mother of the devil's son. The ritual was strong and was performed at night. A month later she felt symptoms of pregnancy. Another woman also had the same pregnancy ritual as my mother. She felt pain in her inner part and felt something penetrating her intimate part. This woman's belly grew, but it was not a begotten child but a fibroid. Satan could not bring forth this child. This woman told her experience to my mother. A week later she had ovarian cancer and her uterus became rotten. My mother could have gone through the same thing, but the Lord Jesus had work in her life. I was born through a semen ritual and started to participate in witchcraft since I was 7 years old. My parents encouraged me in macabre rituals, getting me started in the world of magic. My father died being enslaved by Satan. My mother left the witchcraft and converted to Jesus. My brother was a thief and was murdered by the police. My mother was converted by two North American missionaries who came here on a mission in Mutare. My mother evangelized and prayed for me. I was already 20 years old, had immersed in the black magic and the powers of darkness. I felt a deep hatred for the two missionaries who had rescued my mother from the obscure world of witchcraft. I began to delve into my rituals and began to drink blood from snakes and rats. Satan was telling me through the dreams what I should do to become his son with superpowers. Every night when I was sleeping, a negative energy came into my mind, making me dream of talking to Satan. He told me to kill all the Christians who are hindering his work. I began to send powerful magic to kill the missionaries. A Christian who drove a car with two missionaries came out unscathed from my spells. That scared me. 2 years ago, a Brazilian missionary called Tiago came to do the mission here in Zimbabwe. I had thrown a powerful death spell. He did not die and got sick for a week. When he got better, he returned to Brazil. This missionary had converted several people here in my country. His departure was a victory for me. Without that missionary, Satan's plan was allowed to progress. God allowed the spell to reach him to prove his faith. His thorny mission tested the faith to see if he would continue or make him give up. I received this revelation after I converted to Jesus. When I was deeply immersed in the dark world of darkness, I did not understand why the missionary James did not die after the spell was cast on him to cause his death. He became sick, leaving me curious to know what protected these believers. This puzzled me, and this caused me to strengthen my satanic covenant to gain more diabolical powers. In a vision, I saw a ladder that began on earth and descended into the earthly depths. I was coming down the stairs. Each step that I took, I descended closer to hell. I continued downward and received all the power of hell. I was clothed in the powers of darkness, receiving infernal training. Chapter 2. The Christian and the Armor of God. I cast spells on all the Christians who came to evangelize in my region. The poor community in my village was converting and the number of Christians was increasing. I started attacking several Christians with death spells. I was successful. I killed many evangelicals with terrible infirmities. The demons said, "Attack them, they are not clothed and shielded with the armor of their God." I obeyed this order and I was very successful. Some I could not kill and they got sick and soon they recovered. The demons were passing to me all the information of the Christians. They said, "You must attack this Christian." I would do witchcraft in volleys of black marbles looking like gunshots. Hit those believers. Evil diseases contaminated their bodies. This is the price many Christians pay for defying the powers of witchcraft without living a holy life. If you have not renounced the world and wish to do missions in Africa, do not go as you can be attacked by the demons. Some Christians could not be killed or afflicted with sickness. They were intact and nothing happened to them. I could see the seal of the Holy Spirit on them. They were covered by a fireball in their lives. I asked the demons to reveal the secret of these men. The evil spirit opened my eyes. I saw believers in white armor, with breastplates, shields, helmets, and breastplate protection. They looked like war riders, their armor gleaming. The evil spirit said that these believers are protected with celestial armor and that it was impossible for the spells to enter them because of their protection. In my overall view, more than half of the Christians were dressed in incomplete armor. Some were lacking the helmet, others were without the breastplate, and some without the shield. Those who were missing parts of the armor were struck by the spells on the unprotected body part. Those who had no armor were naked, unprotected from the celestial armor. Many were dying. Every time I wanted to kill a believer, I would look first to see if he had armor. Those who are clothed in the armor of God, my attacks were unsuccessful. The evil spirit who was talking to me said, "You need to perfect your powers. The legion of the air and earth is in your domain and you can do whatever you want. I am a spiritual authority who commands legions and you are the authority that commands a legion. Our authority is the same. You are the son of Lucifer. He chose you from the womb of your mother to perform his work. Principality, when your mother was pregnant, she offered a sacrifice to Lucifer, drinking the blood of the animals and you fed on the blood inside the womb. You have become special to our Father. You are our Messiah. Every work of our Master and his purposes are in your hands. The Principality of Zimbabwe will appear to you in a physical shape, through a strong ritual. But you are not prepared spiritually to get close to the Prince of Zimbabwe. His magnitude is so terrible that his presence will make your body shiver and tremble when he comes close to you." 2 days later, I did not waste my time and went to the cemetery. Upon arriving at the gate of the cemetery, a demon received me. I opened a grave and had sex with the corpse of one person. This woman was dead 2 days ago. I practiced necrophilia. The demons came to me and told me what to do. After the ritual, I was charged with negative energy. The Principality of Zimbabwe appeared to me. He was tall and strong, his body embodying himself as a man. He took my hand and we flew to the great city of Harare. And he took me to several cities until we were transported to another place. He took me up to the tallest building and said, "I will give fame, money, and much success in your career if you realize the great plan of our master. Make an army for our father and he will guide and lead these people what to do. We will reveal all our plans and you will make a book of witchcraft for them to practice. Those who read this book will have their minds taken and hearts infected. I'll give you the revelations for you to write. When the book is ready, you will become known worldwide." That prince of darkness transported me to my city. He poured oil on my head, anointed me with the anointing of darkness. I felt a force take my body. I received an evil covering and saw an infernal mantle covering my body. That oil gave me cover to travel into living hell. No one enters hell with the body of flesh, since it is a spiritual place. If it had not been for the oil that the principality poured over me to get in, I could not enter hell. I also believe that it was God's permission to let me enter that place. I and the principality walked on a path that descended, and the more we walked, the wider the road became. We arrived near a gate that opened by itself, and when we entered, the gate closed. The place is dark and lit with red fire. The souls are trapped there and they do not stop screaming. All the people that do not have a body of flesh, they are spirits. The only one of flesh was me, who was wrapped in an evil coating that protected my body from melting in the heat of hell. The temperature of that place is very high and exceeds more than 500 degrees Celsius. The prince who walked beside me said, "Our father wants to see you." That demon passed through several valleys of hell with me until we reached the black throne. I saw Satan sitting on that throne. He was not in the form of a monster. He was a handsome man and perfect in appearance. He said, "My son, I chose you for a mission on earth. Enter the churches, contaminate their doctrines and spread the lie to the Christians. My enemies are the believers, not the people of the world. Christians have given me harm throughout history. I have gained many souls of believers, I have deceived many souls of believers. I have deceived them and confused them using the Bible itself. Satan showed me a Bible and said, 'This Bible comes with our teaching. It has been tampered with. We are deceiving everyone with our deceptive theology that does not preach against sin. Our liberal theology says that nothing is sin and may have fallen into this teaching. The theology of predestination for salvation is ours. We are using the very word of God to deceive. We use their own weapons, which is the Bible. A small distortion of the word changes the meaning of the message, and you will be an instrument of deception that will bring many here. I have used book theologians to teach falsehood and false Bibles to mislead many. Look to the left of the valley and see the imprisoned Christians. In this end time is easy to win the souls of Christians. At the beginning of the church on earth, it was difficult. The early Christians were more prudent and spiritual. They were real saints who gave a lot of headaches. Now you have to return to earth and fulfill your mission. I saw many souls of Christians in hell and how Satan displayed his trophies. The souls of people who are not believers have little value, the demons do not struggle against them. However, the souls of Christians are a priority for demons. They are fighting to win the soul of Christian because they are promised great rewards. They receive rewards in hell for every Christian they win. Every time a demon managed to take the soul of a Christian to hell, he get great prize and great rewards. Dear believer, do not be outsmart by a demon because of sin and the pleasure of this passing world. Renounce and reject this world. I said to the devil, "Father, let me reign with you in hell, then I would do your mission." He replied, "You cannot reign in this state. Your flesh cannot stand eternity in hell to withstand the pressure of the atmosphere of this place. You are not in spirit yet. Your flesh will rot if you stay more than one day here. Your body is not eternal, and your kingdom will come. When you die, you will reign with me and sit beside me." Satan gave me a burning iron and sent me to torture a soul. I began to torment that soul. The man screamed in despair. The whole evil of hell invaded my heart. The pleasure I felt when I tortured that soul flooded my being. Satan said, "When you are here with me, you will torture many Christians who are trapped in this place." The prince who walked with me took me to earth. I became stronger because I had talked to Satan face to face. I went to test my powers and asked the villagers to bring me a dead animal. I wanted to raise the faith of the people in me by resurrecting the dead. The people of my village brought a man who had been dead one day ago. He had not been buried yet. They threw his body close to me. I made a circle of fire and laid the corpse inside that circle. I performed a ritual and the body began to float. I saw the demons lifting the dead body up. The people were amazed to see the body floating. A legion of demons possessed the dead body, making the man walk without life. The people applauded me, believing the man was resurrected. That lifeless corpse walked about 20 meters and fell to the ground to the disappointment of the people. The demons came out from within that body, proving that Satan cannot resurrect and give life to the dead. Jesus is life and the spirit of life is in his hands. It is only he who can make a person come back to life. I was disappointed as I wanted to have the gift of giving life. If life is in the blood, I thought of doing a blood ritual to receive that gift. The next day I did a ritual donating my own blood. I was weak from the loss of blood and my eyesight darkened. I fell on the floor unconscious and my spirit left my body. A demon appeared to me and led me into a church. He said, "Several people here are playing with their God and pretending to be Christians." My vision was open. I could see dark spots on many people. Many people's hearts and minds were dark. God knows the intimacy of each person and allowed me to see the interior of each person. I asked the demon who was with me if he could see what I saw. He said no, but said he could touch spiritually weak people. I asked, "If you cannot see the inside of a person, it is because that the person does not have God?" He answered me, through spiritual sensitivity, I feel the sin in them. Sin stinks, I smell and approach the person who is in sin. If I do not smell the sin, I do not approach because I know that this person is clean and purified by the blood of his God. The devil began to point out people in the church who exuded the stench of sin according to him. And everyone he pointed out, I could see a dark stain on the inside. That spot he could not see, just me. The demon said, many who are here have their minds contaminated because of pornography. I looked into the heads of many and realized that inside their minds was taken by the darkness. Their minds were pure darkness and the evil spirit flew into their minds. The demon said, I could destroy 90% of this church through black magic. And then the demon began to point out several believers in this church who were living in sin. Then he pointed to 8 members of this church and said, we cannot touch these 8 believers because they have purified themselves and they have kept their garment clean, they are the first fruits of this church, they are the tithing of their God for this church. They are the 10% that are preventing the entire church from being destroyed. They live a life of prayer and they have consecrated themselves, they are the bastions and the pillar of this church. This church had 80 members, in which 8 were untouchables. Later my spirit returned to my body and I woke up at the hospital for the loss of too much blood, high blood pressure, and I went back to my house. The next day, a demon appeared to me and my spirit accompanied him. I went to the air to meet with millions of demons. The demon introduced me in the gathering of millions of demons and said to them, this one here is Ronald, he is one of us, he is not to be considered as a human being as he is the demon himself incarnated on earth. He is the son of Satan and already condemned forever like us to the lake of fire and brimstone. He will work with us causing all kinds of destruction. I and a legion of devils entered the church and studied each person and their weaknesses. Most of the churches in Zimbabwe are in sin, the faithful who follow the true gospel are few. Every day my spirit left my body to find the demons in the air. One day I was in the air together with a legion of demons. Some angels descended from heaven with their swords. These warring angels waged war against that legion that was with me. The demons fled and left me alone. I thought those angels will cut me just like they did with the demons. The blades of their swords were very sharp. They approached me and said, our war is against demons, and souls are precious and dear to God because they are bought at the price of divine blood. Seeing the attitude of each angel I realized that no matter how much God hates the sin, he loves the sinner. The angels went up to heaven and one stayed with me. The angel said, the Lord has allowed his spirit to leave the body and walk with the demons, entering the churches to see the sinner hidden in each life. Your vision was open to see what no one can see. All this was with the permission of God. He chose you out of the darkness to reveal the hidden secret of the demons. That day I realized how strong the angels were as they defeated the legions of demons who were with me. But I had a pact with my father Satan. I was connected to him from my birth. There was a spiritual bond from father to son. I offered money to have sex with a virgin girl. My goal was to bring forth a new son of Lucifer. I invoked an evil spirit to enter my body at the time of sexual intercourse. My body was possessed in the sexual act. The girl left, and a week later she became pregnant with my child. I knew that child was Lucifer's daughter. I was possessed by an evil spirit that I believed to be Lucifer. I do not remember the sexual act of being possessed. 9 months later the child was born dead. I paid a high amount of money for the child's mother not to bury and give me the body. I fed on the blood and flesh of that child because it was consecrated to Lucifer. I was disgusted. I called all sorcerers in a meeting to talk about this matter. One of the sorcerers said that it was not in Lucifer's plan that this child should be born because I was not the right person and had to be a virgin boy in my place. We chose a virgin boy to be an instrument of Satan and a virgin girl and they were both paid to procreate a child. Satan incorporated himself into the boy and had sex with the girl by getting her pregnant after days. We do not know that the evil spirit possesses him, but he presented himself as Lucifer himself. We had a party for Lucifer to learn that the girl had become pregnant. I would register this child in my name. 3 months later, the girl fell to the floor and hit her belly, losing the child to our frustration. Today I know that God did not allow this child to be born. I was very furious and wanted to get revenge because of bad luck. I did witchcraft rituals on the rivers so that the demons possessed the aquatic animals. The fish became aggressive and attacked the fishermen. The fish were sticking to the fishing nets, something that did not happen. A fisherman was attacked by a large fish that almost cost his life. The crocodiles became smarter and began to bring down boats in the water. Many fishermen were devoured by crocodiles. The aquatic animals were agitated and the waters of the river killed many by causing them to be drowned. A demon from the waters pulled people to the bottom of the river. My ritual in the water was taking effect. My spells were so strong that they attacked people at long distances. The victims could even be in another country. I closed many churches with high magic witchcraft. Some shepherds with fear were forced to make a pact with me in rituals. In this covenant, they could open their churches and worship their God as long as they deliver the souls of the sheep to the demons. These pastors paid the tithe of the income of the church to me. I used all the offerings given by the heart of poor people. The shepherds who accepted the covenant with me did not care about the sheep. They only thought about the profit and used the work of God to do business. Those who did not make the pact and tried to carry out their pastoral activities were bombarded with witchcraft and could not resist the demonic oppression. They closed their churches and left to never return. I began to ridicule the God of believers and did not believe him. I thought my demons were stronger. What intrigued me were those angels who had defeated the legion of demons with me. After all, whoever created these angels, I wanted an answer as to why those angels could defeat the demons who lied, saying that Lucifer was the creator. I sacrificed 66 black chickens, 13 black goats on September 11th. Days and numerology are important to Satanism. Every Friday I did rituals. But to make a sacrifice of 66 black chickens and 13 black goats was something special. It took me months to get all those animals of the same color together. After this ritual, I invoked Lucifer to materialize for me. I had many questions to ask. He appeared in my house and said, "Where is the child, my son who was consecrated as my Antichrist? You would be the greatest African wizard if you do not fail." I was a respected wizard. I made lots of money doing black magic work. I had 5 houses, each in a different city. I bought a house in Harare, one in Kadoma, one in Chegtu and the other in Bunduda. I had 3 cars and other goods. All of this cost money of lives that were destroyed by my hands. People paid me dearly to kill, destroy, and end lives life in misery. My money was dirty, it cost blood. Many souls who are in hell because of me. When I converted to Jesus, I sold all the property that cost the blood price and donated the money to an abandoned children's institution belonging to a church. Satan had materialized for me and asked me for a virgin girl. His plan is to build a satanic generation through the seed of the virgin. A demonic fertilization inside the womb of a virgin. I tricked a girl into saying I would give her a job and brought the girl to Satan. When he approached the girl, he began to walk away and said, "I cannot touch her, she is anointed. She is chosen by the man who reigns in heaven." I said, "Dad, you're stronger, now you're telling me there's someone stronger than you? Who is this man? What's his name?" Satan said, "Yeshua HaMashiach." I said, "I did ritual. I spent a lot of money thinking that Satan is the strongest. I did a sabbatical ritual for him. This girl is not a witch, she's nothing special, she's just a poor girl." Satan looked at me and said, "Who are you to speak to me like this? Kneel down and ask forgiveness before me." I said, "You are no longer my God. If there is a God stronger than you, I want to serve him. I will not bow my knee to a God who fears a harmless girl." Satan was enraged and furious, and with his finger, he touched my stomach and said, "Whoever is going to bear a son is you. This will teach you a lesson to never again challenge me." Satan exploded in front of me, turning to a black mist and leaving through the ceiling. The girl who is a servant of God went away scared. Nothing happened to her, but my belly began to grow. That night three devils came to visit me, each of them with whips. One of them said, "Never again will you all rebel against our master. He is your father. We who are greater than you never challenged the boss. Who do you think you are? You are but a mortal." Those three demons whipped me all night. I spent several days in bed with my body cut off, sickened with fever. My mother, who is a Christian, visited me, made herbal remedies and took care of my wounds. She preached the gospel to me. I told her that her Jesus is not strong enough because all the pastors are afraid of me. They make pacts with me not to be disturbed by my spells. Their God is small, he cannot defeat a man of flesh. I want to serve a greater God than my gods. I went to the hospital. The doctor said, "Who are the people who did this in your body?" I said it was a group of men who beat me. The doctor noticed that my belly had a lump. I went through exams and found that I had a tumor. I remembered that Lucifer had touched my belly and said I would bear a child. The doctor said that I would have to go back there for chemotherapy. I did not go back to the doctor and started to do a ritual to be healed. My mother was worried about my health getting worse. I did several healing rituals and the tumor began to grow to be the size of an orange. I knew the spirits had abandoned me because I could not heal my belly. I had cured several people of much worse illnesses and rescued them from the brink of death. The core of my belly was growing and I was in pain. I visited the church where the people were crying. It was the only open church that dared to do its services without compromising with me. My lump burst through the prayers of that people. I was healed of the tumor. Upon receiving this wonderful cure, I gave up terrorizing that little church. God did not allow my rituals to heal me so that his name would be glorified. But Satan, not to lose my soul, appeared in my room saying that he would forgive my rebellion against his authority. And we made a covenant. He said he would give back my powers and still add more to them. This time Satan did not materialize, he came as a spirit. Every time he introduced himself to me, he never came in a form of monster. He always personified as a good-looking man, blonde with blue eyes, tall and strong, with his royalty behavior. He drew my attention to a church that did not tithe their monthly income to me. Satan said he would give me powers to destroy those people. The same church whose prayers healed me and whom I owed my gratitude to, now Satan wants me to destroy. Satan said that I was his son and should not let a mediocre people continue to gain souls within my territory. Those evil words entered my heart. Satan has disappeared but has left my heart filled with hatred. The seed of evil once again was planted in me. I wanted to restore my reputation, but that church was a threat to my kingdom. Since I was cured of the tumor, I began to respect that ministry. I was afraid to face that church and began to study the people of the congregation. I discovered that a missionary was ministering there. And the church began catching on because of his ministry. What struck me was that he began to shepherd the people and everyone had to pray for 1 hour before the service. That church looked like a military barracks of soldiers, they led by Pastor Kenzo, the foreign missionary. To congregate in that church was very difficult. Those who do not like to pray could not stand it. Pastor Kenzo did not accept people who did not like to pray. God has sent this able man to rid the people from the clutches of Satan. He proved the power of the God of believers. The demons were desperate. A demon came up to me and said, "Wizards are giving ear to this church. Their souls cannot be won by them, they belong to our king. You did a great job, but you betrayed your king. He could have given you a kingdom if you had not rebelled against your father. Your rebellion has cost you dearly. This is the result of all those who betrayed the master. You have received a new chance from your father, you have more powers than before. If you betray your father, you will die and lose your kingdom and eternal life. The greatest betrayal is to abandon your father by following the God of believers. Never follow their path, they are our enemies. Any witch who turns to Jesus, his destiny is death. We need you." A missionary has arrived at our country and he is gaining much ground. Many are following him, the signs of Jesus accompany him wherever he goes. Even with much fear of this missionary, I said that I will go to him to prove that I am the strongest sorcerer. No believer has strength against me. I was curious to know who this man is that all wizards tremble. The demon replied, do not go near him, I am afraid of losing you to their god. The sorcerers who come to him are converted to their god. He helped found a wooden church. To destroy this man, do your rituals in your house. Never go to meet him. I was astonished to hear the demon saying such fearful things about that missionary. I thought, is his god so strong? I'll have to investigate this man. I cannot accept someone stronger than me. My thought, full of evil, said, do not accept another man taking over your territory. Many sorcerers, when they came near him, only in his presence fell into demonic manifestations. He was converting the sorcerers of my village and was gaining their souls. The demons, knowing my intentions, warned the sorcerers of my betrayal. Two dangerous sorcerers did works of witchcraft of death to kill me. I got sick, but with the gift of divination, I discovered that both of them were the culprits. I ran over them with several death spells. The two died, and another sorcerer rose up against me. I cast upon him the death demon who entered his son, who murdered his own father with stab wounds. These possession spells I had already done before, making a demon possess a man who took his revolver and shot his friend without him doing anything. When this boy who killed his friend was arrested, he did not remember anything and cried a lot. The spirit of death in possessing him took his conscious mind and controlled him totally. Even though I was the traitor of the demons, I killed three sorcerers. Why did the demons not take away my powers? I discovered that Satan was playing me like a chessboard, trying to convince me to win my soul. A demon appeared to me, I was afraid, I thought he would give me a whipping like the first time. The demon appeared to me and said, the father gave you one more chance, he did not take his powers, despite your intention of wanting to betray going to the church. Our father sacrificed three sorcerers because of you, your soul is worth more to Lucifer than their souls. I said, I do not trust him anymore, I have been deceived several times with false promises. That cunning demon said, you have not respected the master, you defied his power, but in spite of that he still loves you very much. I replied, if he loved me he would not have put a tumor inside my belly to take my life. The demon said, this will not happen again. Enjoy this chance. Today your powers will increase if you obey. In a week I will come back and tell you what to do. I said, okay, give me back my powers. The demon was gone, I felt an evil force taking over my body. I was multiplying all negative energy, I felt the flow of darkness invading my being. The darkness invaded my room, all the malignity took my soul. I could not meet this pastor at the command of the devil. The number of Christians increased in the village, that was too much for me. A stranger gaining more followers than I. It dominated my heart to think I should measure my strength against that church. No sorcerer or Christian had managed to defeat me. For the first time, I was defeated by a missionary, despite my preparation. He was covered in God's armor, from head to toe, like a brass that shines when exposed to the sun. The anointing of God that was in his life threw me to the ground. I was set free for the glory of God. It was through this deliverance that I began to help the work of God. My mother prayed for 12 years for my salvation. She never gave up, and she won the battle on her knees on the floor praying. And it was through Kenzo at Atsushi's ministry that I was converted. Everyone is afraid to face me, he was the only one who could launch a spiritual war against me. The missionaries won many souls, but they fled from me. The only one who confronted me was a Japanese gentleman with a humble appearance in the name of Kenzo Atsushi. So was David, who faced Goliath. David was small, while Goliath was a giant. I was Goliath, a giant in witchcraft who did not believe that a humble person would have the courage to come near me. He is short in stature, but a giant anointed of God and prepared for wars. I was curious to meet him and went to church to challenge him. I failed to subdue him, and the one who came out defeated and in shame was me. When the anointing emanated from his body, my spirit was snatched off. I fell on the floor of the church, and in seconds my spirit was taken to hell. This time I was not in hell with my body of flesh, it was my spirit. According to the church, my body was frozen without a heartbeat. The whole church prayed I would not die. I had earlier gone to hell in a living body, the first time by the order of the demons. Now I was in hell for the second time with my body already dead. I was in the same place of darkness, fire, brimstone, and affliction. But now I was alone and afraid of the darkness. The intense heat choked me, taking my breath away. I was afraid of the demons because my attempt to destroy the church had failed. The demons caught me and led me to the throne of Satan. I knelt down before his throne and said, "Father, forgive me." Satan looked at me and said, "Here you cannot challenge me, I am your king and this place is my kingdom." I said, "Remember, Father, you promised that I would reign with you as Lord." Satan laughed, saying, "How foolish you humans are. Do I end up sharing my throne with you? Take that worm out of here and let him play in the infernal dungeon with the Satanists." Those demons dragged me, I was thrown into a dark prison, all suffering together. An invisible force began to tear apart my bones. The Satanists screamed, "We served the Master, we do not deserve this, the Lord betrayed us, we are sorry to have served the Master." The sorcerers said, "Now we know that Jesus is the way." The more they spoke the name of Jesus, the more the fires burned them and their torments increased. They cried, "My soul has remembered the God of my mother. I invoke Jesus to save me." I was powerless to stand, tired, overwhelmed, and worn out. Suddenly, an angel came down to the prison where I was. The angel took me in my arms and pulled me out of hell. Glory to God, He is the Savior, for He liberated me from the flames and the torment of hell. Beloved, just believe in Him and you will be saved from condemnation. I woke up in the church. I had been unconscious for 1 hour. The service ended 1 hour later because of me. While I did not wake up, they did not leave the church. That night I converted to Jesus and went home. The next day I could not get out of bed, for a demon had appeared in the night and touched my stomach. My mother, seeing me sick and knowing about the devil who came to visit me, called the missionary pastor. He came up to me, placed his hand on my belly. I felt a fire burn my stomach and I vomited the sickness. A ball of blood came out from inside my stomach. I was healed one more time and the missionary returned to his country. I was disgusted with the spirits who worked for me. And I was very disappointed with my master Lucifer, whom I called a father. He had promised his throne to me but deceived me when I was in hell. I saw several sorcerers like me who served Lucifer who are now in hell, all of them were deceived. It stirred my mind and I came to believe that I too had been deceived by these evil spirits. I was convinced that I was on the way to hell by believing Satan's lies. My mother was right, Jesus is the only way. But the fact that I did not see Jesus the way I saw Satan himself, made my faith difficult to believe if he were real. I believed the demons after walking and talking with them for so long. I saw the angels of God warring against the demons, but I thought they were from Lucifer. I could not follow a God I could not see, so far as the Jesus of the believers had not demonstrated his divine power. I was accustomed to the diabolical supernatural, talked to the demons and wanted to see if Jesus was real and strong as the believers say. I converted to Jesus despite having a great doubt of his existence. I abandoned magic and all sorts of witchcraft by discovering that the devil is the father of lies and deception. I wanted to see Jesus and I began to make prayers. I received an invitation to preach in the capital of Harare. Despite my doubts, I was renewed in peace and transformed. All that evil of harming people has disappeared. I got my car and went to Harare. When I looked back, I saw a legion of demons following me. I already knew things would not end well. The demons did not want to lose my soul. I looked and beside me was an angel and in the back seat a demon. The legion behind me rolled my car 2 times in a row in the middle of the road. I saw my wounded body on the floor. A man in white appeared to me and said, "You wanted so much to see the Jesus of the believers, here I am personally, do not fear, I am with you. I'm a real person, I'm not a spirit, touch my hands." I touched the wounds and saw that the body of Jesus is physical. He said, "Tell my church that I live for eternity to eternity. My eyes are on the four corners of the world and I see the suffering of my people and an iniquity of those who say they are my servants. It was I who sent the angel to take you out of hell. I also sent my angel to protect you from that car accident. I did not let your father's semen die in that ritual to make you the fruit of my miracle. I will not let you die. I was resurrected for your sake. I sent my servant Kenzo from a distant place to deliver you here in Zimbabwe. Satan knew of your importance to me. He did everything to make you important to his plans. I allowed all this to happen to you to prepare you on my way. I let you know the world of darkness so that you will know who your true spiritual enemies are. Now I will prepare your life to fight the enemies that revealed so many hidden secrets to you. You know how demons act and know how to deal with them. I have chosen you from your mother's womb to deliver souls who are slaves to Satan." Jesus took my hand and we went up to heaven. We arrived near the river of life. Jesus said, "You need to be clean. Before you were born, my servant, your father's semen was ritualized before it was introduced into your mother's womb. You were offered in the womb to Satan. That is why Satan gave you so much authority and hell power. Since you were a child, you became an instrument of demons. A whole load of satanic energy that is upon you has made it difficult for you to believe in me. For your salvation, today I remove the scales off your eyes. I make you my property. I have a plan in your life. The waters of this river of life will purify your body, soul, and spirit, and a new creature will be born. As I plunged into those waters, dirty water flowing from me began to come out from within me. All my bitterness and sins were taken away. I came out of the water in a new man. Then Jesus took me to the air in the immensity of the universe, where the angels fought a battle for my soul. I was happy besides Jesus. I regretted not having listened to my mother. How much time I lost without serving my God." Jesus said, "Satan promised you a kingdom in hell. He cannot give what does not belong to him. That kingdom in the hell is temporary. Soon Satan will be cast into the lake of fire, like a stone thrown into the river. I can give you an eternal inheritance." Jesus took me to heaven and said, "Look to the saints and see that each one has inherited a part of his inheritance here in paradise. I saw great houses and each one has its dweller inside. Just thinking that I could lose all of this because I was rebellious hurts my soul. I was amazed at what I'm going to inherit soon enough. An inheritance of light different from the sphere of darkness that Satan promised me." Jesus showed me the life of Satan before his fall. In the vision, I saw how he shone and was beaming light like a star. His body was full of precious stones. He was like a prince of great beauty and ruled the earth that was full of precious stones. Some of the angels on earth were ruled by him. From the earth to the heavens there were many roads that gave access to the heavenly regions. Lucifer was like a prince of the earth. He had access to heaven, and ours was a ruler of the earth's treasures. Several angels followed him as an authority. He was a chief and an intelligent cherub in the administration of the kingdom of God on the earth. God entrusted a lot to this cherub. In the vision, I did not see human beings, only angels, animals, and other celestial beings. The throne of Lucifer was on earth and God's throne in heaven. Lucifer wanted his throne to stand on the heights of heaven like a god. His pride and ego inflamed his heart. Lucifer wanted to be God and to be with his throne in the heavenly realms. And he was cast down with a third part of the angels who followed him. He managed to fool the angels with his wiles and together they were cast down. Where the third part of the angels fell into, it was turned into chaos and destruction. These angels were in a simple spiritual sphere that is not the Garden of Eden. Yet God had not created man and the Garden of Eden. I can only report that the earth was adorned with precious stones. When the angels fell on the earth, everything was destroyed. They looked like meteorites falling on earth. Brethren, I am not saying that after this vision you have to preach it in the church. Preach only as far as the Bible commands. I speak about these visions when I relate my testimony. In my preaching, I only speak where the Bible commands so as not to cause debate. In the other vision, God had recreated the world that was covered with water and without form. God did not allow the fallen angels into the recreated world. They were in another spiritual sphere in the part of the universe. They could not enter the terrestrial globe because they were evil. Only the pure ones that entered the Garden of Eden were allowed in. These angels guarded the garden just as Lucifer guarded the mountain of God before his fall. Lucifer possessed the serpent to enter the garden and deceived Eve. The Lord Jesus said he allowed the devil's entrance in the garden to test Adam's faith. Today I understand that everything is allowed by God to test our faith. When the devil tried Job, he first asked permission from God. I was so dazzled by these revelations that I knelt before Jesus. I said, Lord, forgive me, I know that I do not deserve your forgiveness. I killed many people with my magic, I embarrassed your son and may have died by my hands who could be winning souls today. Jesus looked at me and said, My grace has blotted out your transgressions. Now go and save your friends who are in witchcraft. Do not let them come to the same fate of Satan as the lake of fire. Free them from the path of a lie. I said, Lord, I will be faithful to you, I will set the prisoners free in your name. All the damage I have caused in your kingdom, I will work in your work to restore until the last days of my life. I'm going to win more souls to heaven than I've gotten to hell. As I finished speaking these words, my spirit descended to earth at high speed. When I woke up, I was on the floor. That very day I won many souls. I want to thank my church that helped me record this testimony. May this recording reach throughout the whole world, saving lives and warning brothers about the danger of the dark world of darkness. Do not joke about being a Christian, the devil will not play when he goes to collect his soul. Do not underestimate the sin and vanity of this world that can lead you to hell. This world is treacherous, it can overthrow any Christian if he or she do not watch. The power of darkness is terrible if you think it is because you are a Christian, and you can fight against the greatest sorcerers. You are putting your lives at risk. Without prayer there is no preparation for a confrontation. Without holiness, there is no covering of the armor of God. Without renunciation, there is no way to go to battle. May the peace of Jesus and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all the brethren. Amen.